Hello and welcome back to my channel, my name is Gameplay, and today I am playing more of Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag. In the last video I told the two guards that are now hanging. And apparently I still have to tell them. And now, in this game, and well, mostly in Assassin's Creed games, I like to take the roof, rooftop route, or the parkour route, because it's really it's really good in general. You get parkour, and you also get the ability to hide on rooftops. Let's say they randomly decide to lift their heads up and look at the usual parkour zone, and they see you. Then you can just quickly climb on a rooftop, and that's it. You know, I decided to kill him because, you know, like, every enemy is an enemy for a reason. So, yeah. And then, because they were standing in my way, they were an obstacle, and I don't need any more obstacles. Especially the ones I can get rid of. And him, because why not? And now, in this fight, there's going to be a cut, because, you know, it's the same fight as any other, and just because I got into one doesn't mean you have to sit through it and watch me get destroyed and then barely beat everyone. And now, I don't know if they were attacking me. No. My question is, why were they attacking me? They had no reason, they just came up and attacked me. That was the cut, because... you know, that may have been a glitch, and... you don't have to see glitches unless they're in Valhalla. Then the glitches are actually fun, but not the ones where I get stuck. Those are not fun, considering that the loading times are brutal. And as I said, the stealth system is really weird, because I can crouch, so I get detected easily. They're idiots, so the moment I hide, even under them, like you saw there, they will forget about me, but still, I would rather choose them to not be idiots and me to have the ability to crouch. That would mean a lot, and to have more control over what I do in stealth mode. Because you're gonna see, it's really hard to position yourself and to like stay hidden, because I'll have those boxes and it's going to be ridiculously hard to hide behind them, especially because you can't crouch, so those little ones are just so you can jump over them, mainly. And someone somehow saw me, and I didn't. Even with eagle vision, I didn't see them. I understand that there will be some glitches, but too much is too much. Everything has a limit. But you know what? As long as they don't alert everyone else because of something like this, really stupid like this, it's really not that bad. And especially, you can't change the cover, so you're vulnerable in the meantime. And you can't assassinate them, you just run through them. And then they get alerted and you're forced to fight, just because the assassination system is so shit. Look at that, I climbed on the wall and on the boxes, and he had enough time to react, and now I'm in a fight. If you're gonna do shit like this, at least give me the best gear in the game, to make it at least fun or balanced. If you're not going to allow me to use stealth, at least maybe make allow me to have fun while beating them up. And later you'll see that they really do love grenades. Like, I don't know what is their deal with grenades, but they would and they will throw a grenade at their feet just to get you. And they don't even care that their comrades are there. They would throw it in a crowd of civilians, of guards, of anyone. It doesn't matter as long as they get you. I exploded those because why not? It may come in handy later, like maybe there may be a mission later on, like go destroy their oil jars or something, because they'll be less powerful without them, and so it will just be taken care of. Or at least I think so, but the game could just not care of what I did here and just respawn them and send me to do that. And considering that it may be a memory, a full memory, I think they will, because I don't think they created any alternative for this, you know, where you do stuff from you do stuff that you're not supposed to earlier and then you just skip missions. Ooh, I would not do that. Yeah, dude, he was just too close to that pole. Just headbutting that pole. No, not. I would prefer not to. If you're going to make a parkour system on the water, at least make it usable and easy, and not make it failable from game causes. That's not how you do a good parkour system. You just look slightly the other way and he just jumps off.
I've only one pair of hands. Oh, it's no great loss. I've got plenty of cargo here to make a profit on my trip.
Will you stay? And there is also always the option to become a pirate.
Then back to Barbados, to the tedium of domesticity.
Don't settle for tedium. Sail for Nassau. Live life as you see fit.
Haven't I heard that Nassau is crawling with pirates? Seems a very tawdry place.
Not tawdry, liberated.
Oh, God. That would be an adventure. But no. No, I'm a husband and a father. I have responsibilities. Life can't be all pleasure and distraction, Duncan.
Hey, our bonnet. The name's Edward, in truth. Duncan's only a handle.
Ah. Secret name for your secret meeting with the governor.
The governor, right. I think I've kept him waiting long enough.
And the end of the video is approaching. I decided to cut the other part out because it was just me enjoying the parkour and killing some guards. So, you know, just me having fun, not really enjoyable for anyone who's watching. But I did left this shanty in. And so, I hope you enjoyed this video, I hope you subscribe, and have a nice day.